Hello everyone, welcome to ArtWaters Live. We're at the ArtWaters studio. My name is Daniel Crosswaters Bonet. If you have any questions, comments, or feedback, please let me know. Behind me is the musician. I'm going to pour some of my ArtWaters Medium down. Serve. Hey, how you doing? We're going to do an explosion here on our ArtWaters surface. We take a piece of cardboard, we cut it out to about a size this yay and this. Cover it with some clear packaging tape. I dropped one drip of green down, watching that explosion move around. We're moving the surface around. Here we dropped a drip of purple down. I'll take one of our tools here. As you see, the medium I poured down here had some red flare to it. That's due to me dripping my ArtWaters colors into my ArtWaters medium. So you're able to use your mediums as different colors. I take my tool here, it's a basic straw. Looks like fireworks. Thank you, sir. We'll put a light to those fireworks here. And as you see, the green can come onto your straw after you move it around. You can get different colors mixed in with different colors here using your tools. See, it's kind of shaping in different directions. It's due to the balance of the surface. So you ideally you would like a flat level surface. You see, it's kind of moving down. Perhaps I can take a tool here and shift the way the colors move a bit. Something different here. We're going to take any gravity. Thank you, sir. We're going to take the ArtWaters Expander and chip it right down into the center of our medium. So we just put a drop of Expander onto our medium, let the medium grow out here. Thank you for watching. Thank you for tuning in. If you have any questions, comments, feedback, you can let me know at our artwaters.com website. You can tune in live, such as Serve has been. He's been commenting and chatting and letting us know how we're doing here live, which is great. Thank you, Serve. You're able to do that through Twitch, YouTube. And if you'd like to know all the other outlets you're able to watch us on, please check out our Facebook, where I posted about all the 10 and now 11, thanks to Periscope. Thank you, Periscope. Streams that we've been streaming on. As you see, these are all growing. I dropped a drop of Expander onto it, onto the medium, and it's just growing and growing and growing. Serve as a troll. No, he's a good guy. Thank you for all your comments and questions, Serve. You're the man. Yeah, I kind of got the service book. Okay, so now I'm going to take my tool here. As you see, the colors are expanding, and I'm going to bring my tool inwards. There we go. You see how it's creating? And I'm going to wipe my tool off here, and then I'm going to make it nice and clean again, and I'm going to bring it inwards again. There we are. So I'm going to keep bringing these inwards and creating these nice refluxes of the green and inwards into the red type expander that I created. Thank you, Cherry Hippo. She says, not you across waters, you're cool. Thank you. So now we're bringing the, I'm just cleaning the surface off of my tool before I let it go back in. Because if you let it, I love the packaging around here. Yep, you're enjoying the stream. We'll be painting live here Monday through Friday at 5 p.m. We do a live show here on Twitch, YouTube. Whoa, that was a nice one. So I just cleaned off my tool and I'm bringing the white medium into it. It could be all the different colors bringing it in as well. Thank you. Thank you, Cherry, for the thumbs up there. I'll give you a nice thumbs up back. Okay. So we can start from this angle and bring them up as well. So right now we're just doing some quick designs, bringing the green outside after we drop the expander into the colorful medium. So you're able to do this with any amount of colors. So if tune into our previous episodes, if you have any questions, comments, and then let us know at our ArtWaters website if you have any more comments or questions. Here we're going to clean off the brush a little more. We're going to use the purple now. Bring the purple inside. There we are. See that? And it gives a good outline with the purple as well. So you're able to draw, do a lot of different techniques. It's a heart, says Sir. Yeah, there it is. Perhaps. There we are. Right there. Oh, you see it right there, yeah. Thank you, sir. Okay, let's bring that purple back in. Alright, here we are. Just a couple brush strokes here and there is all you need if you're trying to make a completely abstract painting. And if you know what you're doing, perhaps you can make something really unique. And that's what I'm hoping. Somebody can really take control of these ArtWaters paints and make an outstanding painting that, you know, you can show to anyone. You can take it to your craft show. You can take it to your art fair and be the hit of the show with these ArtWaters paints. Birthday gifts, fireworks shows on the 4th of July, stuff like that. Even a heart for the upcoming Heart coming up on the Valentine's show. We're going to be doing a Valentine's show here. But I have the thing on there. Okay. That was a nice one. So now we're able to pick the canvas up. You see how I'm moving the paints around? That's by lifting up the corners of your painting. So you're able to move your painting all around in different directions here. After you've done your quick designs, move them up and down, cover the whole surface of your... There we are, let them flow. Flowing all around, yeah. So now we've created a really unique background to drop more colors on. So we can take our straw here. Make sure you don't paint on the end that has paint on it. Don't make sure you don't blow on the end, I mean, that has paint on it. Blows there, kind of change things up a bit before we drop our colors down. But that's always fun to do. We're just working on the same painting that we started the show off with. Does this have any colors in it left? I think this one might be out here. Let's use this dropper. There we are. We hope you're enjoying the stream. I'm dropping various colors down before I add my ArtWaters Expander, really let them grow out. And we can watch these grow out if we wish to, or we can just add our Expander now. Anything you'd like. Or we can even blow on it some more if you'd like to. We can bring our straw right back out now that we have a... Let's add one more color here. Oh, that one took off. Nice. So we can blow on them as well. Now we can drop some more down. You can even use your paintbrush a little bit. Here I'm using a straw as my paintbrush. Thank you, Cherry Hippo. Thank you. Thank you very much. Or we can add some more ArtWaters Medium to the center of each. Some green medium. Now we'll take our red here. Thank you. I'll take my green medium and put some in here. Every explosion you do is completely unique. Every ArtWaters painting you do will be completely unique. And it'll always turn out perfect. Satisfaction guaranteed. You'll be able to peel your paintings off of these plastic surfaces afterwards. Please check out our techniques page. If you have any questions, comments, feedback, please let me know. My name is Daniel Crosswaters Bonet, and behind me is the musician. And we do our paintings live here Monday through Friday at 5 p.m. to 6 p.m. We're working on improving our stream. I'm going to take my straw that I've been using and slowly move it through the paint. I can't stop moving the straw right now. Okay, I'm not going to stop here until we get, three thumbs up in the chat. How's that? Not going to stop till then. So let's get those thumbs up in the chat, everyone. Whoa, I'm really going on this. Just moving the straw around. And the great thing about ArtWaters is you're able to take your straw, and let's say you're not happy with what you... Let's say you're not happy exactly with the... thank you, everyone. Thank you for the thumbs up, though. That's great. But let's say you're not happy with what you've done. You can blow onto it. So now I've blown onto my painting. As you see, almost everything has been erased. And now it's a brand new surface for me to work with. So ArtWaters, as long as it's wet and you keep working with it, which can last pretty much until you're done with it. I haven't had anyone ever not be able to keep working with it. So now what's great about it is the colors will keep exploding onto it. As you see, let me make a little flatter surface here. And this will all peel off as well. And I'll show that on later episodes. I'll peel this painting right off. And as you see, you can still create the same explosions after you blow on it, even if you kept working on it. You can do this for up to almost 2-3 hours. I've done a certain amount for over 2 hours, so. We're not muted. That was just fun. That was just a fun moment we just had. Okay. We were not muted that whole time. That was just a fun moment. We're going to take our ArtWaters Expander, drop it right in the middle. Ooh, wow, we didn't hit it quite right in the middle. Let's get that blue in there, huh? Whoa. Something like that. No, No, we were muted. We were just sitting there. That was, oh, see the three-dimensional effects, though, that you can get? You can get three-dimensional effects if you're able to swipe it fast enough. So here's a quick example. See how it's kind of looped there? See how it kind of looped right there? That's a three-dimensional effect. So I dropped a bunch of colors into this area. Now I'm bringing them out into whatever land I've created here. And it's creating three-dimensional painting techniques. See that, how it looped over there? And this is really, really cool. I might have added too many different colors here to fully show that, but this has really turned out well, I believe. Hope you're enjoying the stream here. We're going to be adjusting the lighting and the different ways we're able to showcase ArtWaters here on our upcoming episodes. Thank you for tuning in, everyone. Here I'm moving the surface area all around here. And this is the first area. You can see the three-dimensional areas here now. This is the same painting we started the show off with. We're just getting right into it on today's episode, painting right here. And we're hoping you check out artwaters.com. And here we're moving it all around. Thank you, Cherry Hippo. Enjoying the stream. Cross Waters is the real troll. Yeah, I was trolling there, wasn't I? That was hilarious. So this painting's turning out pretty cool. And as I mentioned, if you're ever unhappy with your painting, you bring out your straw. I drip some black onto it. Wow, that black really shot out there. Nice. Black is a very colorful, overtaking color in ArtWaters. Yes, that was madness. A great color that goes with black is red. So you can drop some red down. Then you drop some expander onto the red really shoots out. See that? Once you put the red onto the black, you put the expander onto the red will really shoot out. It's really cool. Then you can take your tools, move the black around, and we're still on the same painting here. We're still on the same one here, so you're able to go through everything. So keep tuning in. Red and black is your favorite? Well, oh, that's a great idea. Thank you, musician. Yeah, I'm going to dump some white into the middle now, due request of the musician. And thank you for that, musician.
Thank you. I hope it works. I certainly hope it works. Fingers crossed.
And my name is Daniel Crosswaters Bonet. If you have any questions or comments, please let me know. Okay. Okay, well, that was pretty unique right there. And if you're ever questioning, whoa. Yeah, that's a great idea. Per request of the musician again, we're going to use some expander now. Whoa. Okay. Pretty nice idea there, Mr. Musician.
I've seen you do that before, dude. You're good at that. I learned from you. That's why you do it. Thank you for doing
that. Okay, wow. What a painting, huh, folks? So if you're ever unhappy, though, just start from scratch. You take your straw here. Create a brand new explosion. One drop of expander, and you got a brand new explosion of colors. And you just bring out your straw or tool, and you just keep working on the same amount of paint that you dripped down originally. Do a couple of swipes here and there. And then you have your painting. I recommend videotaping your paintings. Once you videotape your paintings, you're able to hang it on the wall, maybe peel it off, have your peel off, maybe your jewelry. Somebody says, hey, how'd you get that? You show them your video. You show them your video of you creating it. Angry Pig 2016. Hey, how you doing? We're moving our colors all around. Whoa, we got a stream here. You're able to get your fingernail in there, as I mentioned. Wow. Okay, those are a little dark and strange, but who doesn't like that? I hope you're enjoying the stream. We're going to watch this painting grow a little bit, move around here. I'm going to wash up, and we're going to start another painting here live at ArtWaters Studio. We're in Las Vegas, Nevada. Behind me is the musician. I am Daniel Crosswaters Bonet. If you have any questions, comments, feedback, please let me know. Okay, set this painting aside and cherish it always after we peel it off. It's got a lot of memories inside of it. Those are the type of paintings that I recommend people you do using ArtWaters. You really have a lot of leverage and room. There's infinite possibilities with just one area of paint. And I recommend always painting on these plastic surfaces. This is a piece of cardboard I cut out. And I layer it with plastic tape. Put the plastic tape. This is shipping tape. We reuse these here on our show. Thank you. nice surf. Here I'm picking up the surface here, moving it in different directions, letting the paint flow wherever I'd like it to. You can also shake it up a bit to let them combine. Let's say it creates a certain thing. Thank you, Cherry Hippo. That's very kind of you. Putting out all the nice flames here. And I'm just shaking it up, you know, like getting in the groove here. Now that the music has stopped for a second, I will stop as well. Okay, it's back. Nice. Okay. We have a nice surface to paint on. I usually recommend covering your whole surface, maybe even letting it flow off of each side, really letting it flow, have the whole surface covered. But here we're just doing some cool tests. Everything we do here is completely random on the ArtWaters show. The wrong bottle there. There we are. Drop of blue here. Right next to it, we'll start a drop of, let's see, pink. We'll have two nice explosions side by side here. That'll be fun to watch. We'll have the start with a blue, start with a pink. We start at 5 p.m. here. We do a live show Monday through Friday. We stream here at Las Vegas, Nevada. You can contact me if you have any questions or comments. My name is Daniel Crosswaters Bonnet. Behind me is the musician. We're watching these two explosions grow out. We have our blue growing and our pink growing. One drop of purple inside of my blue there. Thank you, Cherry Hippo. One drop of green now into my pink. We'll take our pink here and drop it into our purple and blue. About three drops there of pink. And we'll lift it up a little more here. Thank you for tuning in, everyone. Thank you for watching. Questions, comments, feedback on how our stream is doing. We're streaming on 11 different outlets right now. You can check out our Facebook and check out which outlets we're streaming on. We're mostly streaming on Periscope and Twitch that we're getting mostly involved in right now. So tune into Periscope and Twitch, everyone. Also YouTube Live. I'm taking some yellow. One drop of yellow there. So I dropped three colors into each explosion. I'm ready for my ArtWaters Expander. So I'm going to take my ArtWaters Expander and drop one drop down. Then we'll drop one drop down into our other explosion. Yeah, we use restream.io to stream all of our different outlets here. So here's our classic blue, purple, and pink explosion. And here's our classic green, pink, and yellow explosion. If you have any questions, comments, feedback, check out our YouTube. We have archives of all of our videos, and you can email me personally through Facebook, anything you'd like. We have a contact as well on our thing. You can email us on our website, ArtWaters on our thing, ArtWaters.com. You can email us. Yeah, and the cool part is now we're able to use our tools, straws, toothpicks. So I'm going to take my toothpick. I'm going to really get into this one. You can create like a flower, bring the stem down, whatever you'd like. You can start doing designs. You can pour the medium right in the middle. We've been showcasing all these different ways of using art waters. And we're just starting. There's going to be some big things coming up, so be sure to keep tuning in here at the ArtWaters Studio. We're live in Las Vegas, starring the musician. And I, Daniel Crosswaters Bonnet. We have our straw here. It's a little dirty on one end. We're going to use the other to paint with. Or we can use a paintbrush as well. Might have one handy around here. Here we are. We have our paintbrush. Ta-da! So we'll use a paintbrush here. And there we are. Wow! So now you can see the colors are going into what I painted in there. You can see it just from a dab or two. The colors from the outside will start to flow in. It's a little technique here and there that we're showcasing. We're not trying to show too much because then it will perhaps limit what you will all use art waters for. But as you see, just a couple dabs there. Yeah, dabs. So you're going to want to clean off your brush now. Wipe it off here, and you can take it a little and use it in the purple. And just a little squiggle there, and now the purple will be on the brush, so you can, well, maybe you should get a little more, maybe right there, nope. But there's definitely white on our brush now. A nice squiggly line. We need a little more there. But as you see, the paints are flowing now into the crevice that I painted with. So I made a little crevice, and the paints are now flowing into it. It's very fun stuff. We're just doing little tiny dabs here and there. Bringing that green into the area. Maybe we'll just, okay. Maybe that was a little too much. Well, we're trying to make like a flame, perhaps. Two flames. I'm not sure. Let's bring out the toothpick here. Maybe it will explain such things. I'm really not sure what to do here. Not the greatest at using these paints. I'm sure there's someone out there who can become the greatest art waters of all time. That's why we're doing these streams. We're hoping to showcase our art waters paints here, showcase all the little different techniques you're able to do. And maybe I will be the first to make a grandstand on these paints. Who knows? So keep tuning in. Perhaps I'll make something out of this world one day. Thank you, Cherry Hippie. Yeah, yeah. Perhaps. Here I'm pouring some ArtWaters green and ArtWaters red down into the centers of my explosions. As we continue to work on these, we're having fun. We're having a lot of fun here chilling out with the musician. And I, Daniel Crosswaters Bonnet. So if you have any questions, comments, or feedback, please let me know. I'm going to take our straw here. There we are. A couple nice flowers. Or, yeah. Okay, nice. Now all we need are the eyeballs. We're making a couple elephants here. Apparently we got the ears, we got the... Oh, wait. Are those eyeballs forming in this one? So we have eyeballs already. And this... Ooh, whoa. Cool, we're having fun. Hope everybody out there is having fun. We're at the ArtWaters Studio live in Las Vegas. There we are. Got my tool ready. I'm going to dab some purple here. Maybe that was a little too high. Maybe I should add it a little lower. Oh, yeah, that looks good. It goes with the theme. A couple elephants. Like sea creature elephants, perhaps. Doing the dab, yep. Thank you for tuning in, everyone. We do our show Monday through Friday at 5 p.m. End our show around 6 p.m. Catch the different angles of this one before we completely change it. So the way you completely change your painting is by just blowing on it with your straw. So I've been showing you how to use your straw as a paintbrush, but now we're going to blow on our painting, completely change everything. So we just blew on it a bit, and that got me out of breath, but that was fun. And now we have a bunch of different designs. Now we're gonna keep dripping our colors, and you're able to keep doing this for hours and hours and hours and hours on the same one. Mind blown. Thank you, Cherry Hippo. Okay, so sometimes when you drop one color, you hold it down a little too thick. Here's how I suggest dripping it. You create an equator using your index finger and your thumb on the top, and now you create the same equator using your index finger and your thumb on the other hand. Now you're able to squeeze as hard as you want on this, and once you squeeze on this area, the paint will come out one drip at a time. So if you're ever teaching somebody how to use ArtWaters, have them create the equator, create another equator with the other hand, then you're able to drip. We're adding some yellow. Wow, that was nice. Whoa. Okay. Sometimes when you drip the colors, they'll create a ball of a bubble, perhaps, and they'll just roll around sometimes. It's very cool to watch. That's why I suggest always videotaping your explosions. They'll always turn out completely different. But as you see, I blew on my surface, and now I'm able to drip my colors down. They'll keep expanding and expanding as long as they're still wet. And you can take your tool here as a plastic. Or just kind of that's what we're doing. Okay. We kind of joined them together here. We made them one, perhaps. And now we're ready for the expander. This is all non-toxic, water-soluble liquid. Okay. Couple drips of expander here and there, and wow, what is happening? We're having a really fun time painting here tonight. We're doing an hour-long show. We've created a painting to start the show off. Now we're creating another painting to end the show, perhaps. We might do one more. Let's see what time it is. About 13 till the show ends, so probably going to have to keep working on this one, and then you'll have to tune into the next show. We're going to keep doing all sorts of stuff. It looks like it's dying. That's funny. The one looks like a flower. It looks completely different. Thank you for your comments, Cherry Hippo and Evil Toaster 18 and Serve says it's trippy. Thank you very much. And if you're ever unhappy with your painting, you're going to just take your straw out. And let's look at this one more time before I blow all over it. Change it up. You're able to move it around as well. That's also what. Here, let me show you one other technique. Instead of blowing on it, you can shake it. So we're going to just shake it. See how I'm shaking it? See, I'm just shaking it up, and you see how the white's coming up? See how that white came up? It's almost as if I just blew on it, right? So now I'm going to do the same thing I've been doing, just creating an explosion in the center. And it's still going to work as if you just put it down, because it's still just as wet. And it'll work for hours and hours. Yeah, I shook it. Thanks, Surf. Thank you, Cherry Hippo. Yeah, these paints have infinite possibilities. We're here. Thanks to everyone tuning in. Thanks to everyone who's ordered ArtWaters. Thanks to everyone who's one drop of expander down. Watch it all just come alive. Thank you, everyone. Cherry Hippo says Michael J. Fox would be great at that. That is funny. Thank you for your comments and jokes and everything. It just means a lot to us here at ArtWaters, and I'm sure the musician appreciates it. Okay, so you can see the overflow. Yeah, these paintings. You can pick up the different surfaces and move them around. There we go. As you see, I let them flow, so the paints are flowing now down towards me. So I'm going to take my tool here. I've been using a straw here. I'm going to wipe it. I've also used a paintbrush, all sorts of things. There's really not much I can adjust here on this painting. It looks pretty nice, but there's always something you can do. It's kind of just do the, yeah, that was good. That was pretty good. You know, just a stroke here or there. Yeah. Okay, so let's bring it from this point now. That was nice right there. It looks like the white parts are perhaps the birds feeding. I don't know. This is so crazy. Okay. Yeah. And this is just a straw we're using right now. Having a lot of fun here live. We're gonna take it right here. Nice. That was good. I like that. Yeah, it created like an insect realm, perhaps. I don't know. It's all. Maybe I could have. Who knows? If you have any questions, comments, feedback, we appreciate all the. DJ Nanook. Thank you very much, DJ. Okay, I like that a lot. So that created a real bond between these two, because these are two different elements here. And we stream Monday through Friday, starts at 5 p.m. We go till 6 p.m. We kind of just started here streaming live. We started in the last couple weeks, so thank you to everyone with all their questions, comments, feedback. DJ asks where you can find some stream keys, info for casting. Yeah, you just go to the settings here and maybe you can Google it even, perhaps. Okay. Yeah, you can contact me. I can go through step by step if you ask me personally. Yeah, I know where all that is. After my streams are, I can help you with that. Thank you for tuning in. Yeah, please let me know if you have any questions or comments. Yeah, if you can't find it on Google, just let me know and I'll help you out. Here, we're going to take our straw here and move this down here. Ooh, now maybe we'll want to release some of that. Okay, I'm going to move this down. And around and all about. Wow. Very cool. I hope you've enjoyed the stream tonight. Here we'll take our previous painting we worked on. Out of this red medium. I hear it coming in though. I hear it bubbling in. There we are. Just enough. I'm going to keep working on this previous painting here to end up the episode here. We hope you've enjoyed our live stream. Okay, I couldn't get quite much out of that, so we're going to use our white mediums here. Chocolate milk painting, yeah. Okay, so we turned that into a star once again, and we're going to see what we can do with this. We drop some black down into the center. We're going to hit that with an expander. Actually, let's drop a color into it. Let's drop some green in before you hit it. There we are. One drop of expander. Let that black and green explode out into each crevice here that we've created. Let's move this around in different directions. Might have went a little overboard, but that's what the actually we can drop some more, pour some more white medium into this. Oh, he has some yellow here. Yellow's always nice, right? Who doesn't like some yellow? Looks like the black and green is taking over the yellow here really quickly. Let's work fast. Wow. Yeah, we have a lot of paint to finish off the episode here tonight. Let's get the purple in there. Oh, the expander. Great idea. That'll fight the attack of the colors here. Whoa. Okay, wow. The fight has begun. Expander against color. What? Okay, and then you shake it. Wow. This is really, really nice. We hope you've enjoyed the show today. Let's take a look at our other painting here. And on that, we're going to end the show. We hope you tune in tomorrow. Yeah, really marbled. Great. Look at that. It's an amazing marble. Thank you, Cherry Hippo. Wow, really amazing stuff. Okay, there's our previous painting, and on that, we're going to let these dry. Oh, we don't want to hit that too much. But hope you enjoyed the show. We're going to be back tomorrow. Thank you, everyone. Thank you very much. Thank you, Evil Toaster Space and Cherry Hippo for the everything. Thank you, everyone. We'll be back tomorrow. Thank you. Good night.